made and not have strewed thy grave.
Oh, treble woe. Fall 10 times treble on that cursed head whose wicked deed thy most ingenious sense deprived thee of.
Hold off the earth a while till I have caught her once more in mine arms. Now pile your dust upon the quick and dentil of this flatter mountain you have made to o'ertop old Pelion or the skyish head of blue Olympus.
What is he whose grief bears such an emphasis?
Whose phrase of sorrow conjures the wandering stars and makes them stand like wonder-wounded hearers.
This is I, Hamlet the Dane!
The devil take thy soul! Mark, prayest not well. I prithee take thy fingers from my throat, although I am not splenitive and rash. Yet have I in me something which let thy wisdom fear. Hope off thy hand!
Pluck them asunder!
Hamlet! Hamlet!
Good my lord, be quiet.
Why, I will fight with him upon this theme until my eyelids will no longer wag.
For my son, what theme?
I loved Ophelia! 40,000 brothers could not with all their quantity of love make up my sum. What will that do for her?
Go, oh, he is madly at ease.
For love of God, forbear him.
Swoon, show me what thou do. Would weep, would fight, huh? Would fast, would tear thyself, would drink up. I shall eat a crocodile. I'll do it. Dost thou come here to whine, to outface me with leaping in her grave? Be buried quick with her, and so will I. And if thou prate of mountains, let them throw millions of acres on us till our ground, singeing his pate against the burning zone, make ossa like a wart. Nay, and thou'lt mouth. I'll rant as well as thou.
This is mere madness, and thus a while of fit will work on him. Anon, as patient as the female dove, when that her golden couplets are disclosed, his silence will sit drooping.
Hear you, sir. What is the reason that you use me thus? I loved you ever. But it is no matter. Let Hercules himself do what he may. The cat will mew, and dog will have his day.